files across a wilderness of sagebrush and granite, feared as the great American desert. The trail from St. Joseph followed valley, crossed the Rocky Mountains, circled the Great Salt Lake, and passed over the Sierras to Sacramento. The first ponies left the terminal stations on April 3rd, 1860. More than 190 stations, often located in general stores, 400 station men, 80 riders, and 420 horses were needed to maintain the Pony Express. Delivery of letters and news dispatches to California had required months of travel by sailing ships, later 30 days by mule train, and still later 20 days by overland stages. Now the Pony Express offered delivery in 10 days. All letters were enclosed in 10-cent stamped envelopes. The rates charged for carrying the letters by pony were $3 for each half ounce to Salt Lake City and $5 to California. No special pony stamps were used in the first months of the express. The envelopes were franked with a running horse seal when dispatched. Letters received by train from eastern states were assembled with telegrams, news dispatches, and local letters by the express office. They were wrapped together in oil silk to keep them dry. A way bill was signed by the terminal postmasters and enclosed with each group of letters. It was to be signed whenever the mail pouch was opened along the trail. A leather saddlebag called a mochila was used to carry the mail. The mail and way bills were carried in the pockets of the mochila. The pockets were called cantinas. They were carefully locked to protect the mail. One cantina was opened by the postmasters along the trail. The others were opened at military forts and terminal stations. The Pony Express riders were called couriers. The couriers were young men selected for their nerve, frontier experience, and general fitness. They were armed, but depended on the speed of their ponies for protection. Their work was full of adventure and often danger. They rode day and night. Only one mochila was used on a trip. It was transferred from horse to horse and rider to rider on its long journey across the frontier. An average of 15 pounds of mail was carried in the four locked cantinas.